We're here in the evergreen state of Washington. We're gonna head to Port Angeles and go to the best dispensary there, Spark It.
Hey Manny.
Hey Nick, how you doing?
Yeah, great. We knew you were coming. Good to see you, my friend.
I told you I'd be down here in
Portland. Yeah, yeah. So we put out a little spread for you.
Oh, I love spreads. You know you guys love spreads too, right?
So yeah, we didn't think you'd be able to get through it in the next 2 hours.
No, we're probably not going to get through this in the next 2 hours, but I would love to talk about what you got ready for me.
Yeah, well, we got a variety of joints for you. Started from small half-gram joints just to get you warmed up. Things like Tropco G.
Right. Yeah, that'll get me warmed up for sure. That'll get me
warmed up. Tropics, especially in the weather right now.
Now, is this... What is this? Looks like a blunt.
Well, these, yeah, this is a gram and a half of flag ground up, and they fly the banana leaves in from India, wrap it, and it's the smoothest
banana
smoke.
Banana leaf from India?
Yeah.
And they wrap the marijuana in the banana leaf?
Exactly. It's such a smooth smoke. Even novices don't cough. It's great for that.
I see you got a few cyclones here too, correct?
Yeah.
You call them cyclones out here in Washington?
They all have different names. This one's a candy cone, where they just put a bud, paint on the BHO, and then roll it in keef.
All right.
So we've got different varieties of those.
Now, what about this? This is a vape pen, correct?
Correct, yeah. This one doesn't obviously have any product in it,
right. Mm-hmm.
But they're real easy to use. Nice, simple features, discreet. So lots of people like to use them. Quick little hits.
Is this a refillable?
Yes, this one is. It comes apart quite easily. And then we've got different concentrates that you can put in there to refill. So you just refill
it. Now, can you make your own concentrate? Because I heard that you can make a concentrate out of taking some of the wax paper, what's it called? Parchment paper?
Right. Washington State, you're not allowed to use things like butane or any chemicals like that. It's illegal unless you have a license. So you've got to be a recreational licensed person to make that sort of concentrate.
Okay. All right.
The bubble hash and things isn't a flammable liquid. So
if
you want to buy some flour, which we've got all in front of you.
Right. So now let's talk about the flowers you have. Cherry pie, I know it's a common flower here in Washington, right?
Yeah, good flavor for one.
It is.
The most popular one right now is this Gorilla Glue. That one's joints in there, but that's the one that's hottest in town.
Gorilla Glue.
Yeah, and they come with great labels.
We got Tangy.
Black Domino, a real good medical one.
Black Domino, like my son Dominique. We got North Coast Growers.
Yeah, and that's a nice tsunami.
Sour tsunami?
High CBD strain, so you don't have the psychoactive effect. Yep.
What the hell? What is this?
Yeah, this is, you know, when you graduate, you can actually have a big joint, a real man's joint. 14 grams, half ounce ground flour. So as they say, who wants the party?
Oh, we love parties. That joint. Man,
the competition is, can you smoke it all in one go?
No, I cannot. If I was King Kong, I probably could. But so then we're moving on now. You got some chocolates.
Yeah, we've got a whole bunch of different chocolates. Of course, peanut butter is always a popular one. People always like their peanut butter. Brownies. These are new in to the state. Fruit chews. So a bit like Starburst.
Yeah. Now the fruit chews, these are really big in Colorado. The fruit chews. However, I think they're taking them off the shelves now due to lack of education.
Okay.
You know what I mean? The parents aren't being too educated or being educated enough on with the fruit chews.
Yeah.
You know, but they're being really big on that.
Washington State has tried to stop anything that might be attractive to kids. So things we used to, on the medical side, have lollipops, mm-hmm. but we're not allowed to sell those. They're too attractive to kids.
Right.
And all the edibles in Washington State, 10 milligrams is the highest dose you can put in a single edible.
Right.
So like this packet is 100 milligrams,
right.
but they're all 10 milligrams and there's 10 in there.
So like me, I'd have to eat like 10 of them, right?
Yeah, yeah. Exactly. And then, 10 virgin
like
ones, you mean?
Like 20 of them would be all good. So you got the blackberry indica.
No more indica, and as you probably all know, the indica is more the relaxing ones. It's a general term used. It's some people arguing there is an indica and sativa. It depends how you grow it and what nutrients, but most people understand indica is inducing in the couch.
Yeah.
And sativa is energy in the sun, having fun, getting right. stuff done.
Indica in the couch, sativa is fun in the sun.
Yeah, exactly. Okay. And hybrids is a balance of both.
Fun in the sun. Got my little sunshine going on.
Okay, these are some of my favorite because it's Nasty Jack's malt balls and they use the English recipe rather than the American Whoppers, but they're a little bit like Whoppers, but much, much better. So I'd recommend you eating that whole packet, Manny.
Hey, chocolate and me, we're like best friends, I'll tell you what. All right, I appreciate that. I'm gonna put that right there.
And then either for your tea or your coffee, because we have coffee and K-cups.
Coffee?
Yeah. So just put in your K-cup, infused coffee. So an extra buzz in the morning to keep you going.
I love that, buzzing in the morning. Wake and bake, right?
Wake and bake.
Yeah.
Or have it later on and enjoy your ginger snaps with them.
Oh, yeah. Your ginger snaps with some coffee.
That's happy snaps.
Ice cream with the root beer that we had in Colorado. Well, ginger snaps with coffee.
Unfortunately, we're not allowed ice cream here because we're not allowed anything that's refrigerated, but we do have some great products that you can pour on top of ice cream, such as Simple Syrup, which is this guy.
This one,
yeah, something special. Habanero sauce, so you can put it on your wings, ribs.
It's got THC in it.
Oh, yeah, it's loaded with THC.
It's got THC in it.
Yeah.
Man, that's crazy.
So put it on your salad, ribs.
Well, could you just say you wanted to be a little THC one on, you wanted to just...
Well, one of the better things for that would be the little shots.
Okay, no.
30 milligram shot.
No.
So it's like a 5 energy shot. That should keep you going for about two
hours.
5 hour
energy.
Yeah.
This is like that.
2 days, you'd probably be buzzing on that, Manny, knowing you.
3 days. No, 2 hours maybe.
And then, you know, of course, we have some great drinks. So if you have a party, you don't have to have beer, you can have THC-infused drinks.
See, and we have the THC-infused drinks in Colorado as well, too. We have the root beers. We have the colas, all kinds of colas, you know what I mean? But as far as the hot sauce, man, you have so much stuff here that's just amazing. It's just amazing. This is the soda? This is the soda, correct?
Yeah, soda.
From Washington. Make sure you come and try this right here at Spark It. Okay, in Port Angeles. Can you put that over there?
Sure. And another new product is, if you're feeling a cold coming on in the wintertime, you can have the emergency CBD. So you get all your vitamin C, or vitamin C, I should say, for you guys, and THC. What could be better? Yeah. So that's a good one for especially wintertime.
Yep.
One thing we're really proud of in Spark It is we had our medical side. We were able to grow in Washington State.
Mm-hmm.
And one of our business partners, he actually gave a lot of his strains, most of his strains, to the I-502 market so that we could keep
the
them.
The I-502 market, what do you mean by I-502?
That's the what the recreational market in Washington State is called. That's the bill that passed
the
I-502.
Okay.
So you've got to be a licensed grower to grow in Washington State, and you've only got a small window to get strains into a grow. Basically, when you're setting it up, new strains can be introduced. So we do things like our CBD Skunk Haze. It's been really good for our business partner who has seizures. It's been one of a great strain for him. So we've got that into the actual I-502 market. We've got some AC/DC in. We've got things like Black Russian, which is a real nice smoke, good for the body and everything. Real nice smooth smoke. So we're really proud to be able to give those plants to the growers and then get the product back, basically.
Okay, all right. That's good. So now, you say you talk about your marijuana here that's in the package. I've heard that you can't own a dispensary as owning a grow house here in Washington.
That's correct, yeah. The regulations say you can grow marijuana and you can process it. You can own each of those businesses. But if you have a retail business, that's all you can do. You can only buy product in and sell it. You're not allowed to grow it, process it, or do anything else. So we, in the store, buy the product ready packaged, sell it to the customer, we scan it out, and then it's gone. Because in Washington State, when the plant is about 6 inches high, it gets a barcode, everything taken off, it gets weighed and measured, and is tracked. The traceability system goes all the way through to the sale.
Right, and that's how it is in Colorado too. They get the barcode, you know, and it's tracked all the way as well too. Yeah. So. Man, you got a wonderful spread here, man. I tell you what, man, this is good. Thank you. I appreciate it, man.
Well, we got it out for you, and we want to see how much you can do in a day.
Let's start with these mothballs, and then I'll work my way from this way and go to that way, because I want to end up with that syrup for sure. So, okay. But
a bit of lip balm.
A bit of lip balm. We'll talk about that over here. We need a little bit.
See you soon.
Wendy, how you doing?
Hey! How you doing?
You
made it.
Yeah. You know, it was a little drive up there from the port. Is that where we were?
Yeah, we were out at the Spit by the Coast Guard base.
The Spit, the Coast Guard base.
Don't ask me why they call it the Spit. I have no idea. But yeah, that's what it is.
So, moving on. So tell me a little bit about what you got. I know your husband had a really good spread for me over there. You have a good spread over here, too.
Yeah.
Just different. Can you tell me a little bit about that?
Yeah, this is kind of our roots. Okay. This is how we got started. So when we started medically, my background in nursing brought in a lot of patients, and most of these people really didn't want to smoke. They were very fearful of it, and they didn't want to get high either. And so I was like, wow, you know, not getting high with cannabis. Yeah. Hmm. So that's
what can we do? Right? Because I mean, I've heard there's a lot of products out there that you can use, and check into this, because if you want to do any of these products and not get high, not to get the head effect, correct? There are products out there that can help you and still, you know, not get the head effect. So go ahead.
Yeah. So we started basically specializing in non-smoking, non-psychoactive remedies.
Non-psychoactive remedies.
Yeah. And so THC is the cannabinoid that everybody's most familiar with, mm-hmm. but there just happens to be 59 others. And CBD is one of those.
Okay.
And CBD is cannabidiol. And Dr. Sanjay Gupta did an amazing job on CNN. Getting America really to wake up how amazing CBD really is. And I've had some pretty fantastic successes with it in here. So let me kind of walk you through like how I would deal with a patient. So yeah, let's start with something that you're gonna be familiar with.
Mm-hmm.
This is a vaporizer pen.
Okay.
So when we vaporize, we're not combusting. And when we're not combusting, we're not inhaling superheated gases. And so lung damage tends to fall dramatically when you're vaporizing, which is pretty awesome. But the cool thing about vaporizing in patients is that the inhaled route, when you inhale cannabis, the relief that you get from it is immediate, right away.
Right.
There's no hanging out and waiting for it to happen. So my patients have told me that, you know, taking a couple sips from their vape pen, like before they go in and get their chemotherapy, really helps them not only with their anxiety, but their nausea to get through that situation.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And so that has been a really, really wonderful thing for them.
See, and I have my cousin also who has cancer, stomach cancer, Lee Madrid. Shout out to you. And, you know, I got a buddy of mine trying to work with him so that we can take care of him down in Colorado too. So all of this is very, very, very important to everybody, and for everybody to know too. So,
yeah.
Can we jump onto this cannabis quencher?
Yeah, absolutely. This is one of my favorites. So, when we have drinks like this, the cannabis quenchers and the legal sodas, they can do two things.
Cannabis quencher. Buy one now.
You can use them like a tincture and just hold it under your tongue until you start feeling an effect, and then you can swallow it down. Mm-hmm. And when you swallow it, it's got to get metabolized in your liver. So you can get an immediate effect from the way that it reacts with the nerve endings under your tongue.
Mm-hmm.
And then, depending on your metabolism, a half an hour, 3 hours later, you can have a lasting effect from drinking this on. Yeah, and it can last anywhere from 8 to 20 hours. So people can get a ton of relief from a very small amount.
Like me with my foot, because it's a constantly hurt. I blew my ankle out and it constantly hurts.
Yep.
Constantly. So this would be something perfect for my pain for my ankle.
Absolutely. Okay. And because this is a what we call a one-to-one, so there's
a one-to-one meaning that the THC and the CBD share an equal part, correct?
Bingo.
Okay.
Yeah,
okay.
You got it. So one-to-ones tend to be non-psychoactive.
Okay.
For most people,
right.
But they're just really nice anti-inflammatories,
mm-hmm.
and a lot of pain comes from inflammation. So if you can control inflammation, you can knock down pain.
See, and that's what I have is inflammation in my foot as
Absolutely,
well.
Yeah.
You know, walking all over Washington really tore my ankle up, but
I love it. No.
So, can we? What the?
What is?
What is this?
It's says,
come on.
It says O on it.
Says,
it
says oh. Well, oh. Let's show the camera.
Oh,
it
baby.
Says, oh, I can't show you the bottom yet, but it says O. Why don't you tell them a little bit about that, and then you can show them the rest of it. That's.
This is, ladies, this is a sex lube.
Oh, no.
Oh,
a
yes.
A THC sex lube.
Yeah.
I'll come back to Washington for sure.
It's been really wonderful,
right,
for several different reasons. Now, we might be jumping into TMI here,
right,
but,
yeah.
You know, for
right.
women going through the change, things get a little...
Mm-hmm.
Like the Mojave.
Yeah, no, I got you. So
and
what better than THC lube?
Exactly. And we have receptors all over our skin.
All over.
Everywhere on our skin, which makes topicals fantastic. But for, you know, not only for pleasure, but for women going through the change.
Yes, through the change of life.
This
right,
helps
right.
a lot.
Yes,
a lot.
That's good.
Yeah.
And it's another good, really good medicine.
Exactly.
Yep. So I mean, it's just not a lube. It's actually a medicine, right?
Mm-hmm.
Correct. That's good. I like that. So.
Yeah.
I'll take 20 of these.
20.
Yeah. Vroom, vroom.
You're a busy man.
Yeah. So let's move on right here.
Well, some of the other really wonderful things that we have are these patches, and they're transdermal patches, just like a pain patch you would get from the hospital. So you can put a
cannabidiol
that's pure CBD. So non-psychoactive, awesome anti-anxiety. And if you don't want to smoke, don't want to drink,
so
you don't want to eat.
Has anxiety, they just slap one of these on it and it helps them out.
Yep.
Why wouldn't you do that?
PTSD, our veterans really, really like these.
That's brilliant.
Yeah,
who
they're awesome. They're just awesome. And then from Ocorp, we have these sublingual slips. So these are like the Listerine breath slips, but you just pop them under your tongue. And they're incredibly discreet, you know? And they're pretty tasty. They've got kind of a peppermint mocha.
This is something else. And you got them in 5 different flavors?
Well, no, they're all the same flavor, but there's indica, sativa, hybrid, a CBD 1-to-1, and a pure CBD. So they just really covered their bases. We've got all manner of spray tincture, we've got some really cool topicals that are transdermal topicals that penetrate the skin and go into the bloodstream.
Mm-hmm.
And then we have ones that would be awesome for your ankle, like this muscle melt. It's got a little bit of heat to it. He's like, I'll just slide that in the pocket out the door. And then if you're really hurting,
right.
Epsom salt, THC,
all
soak.
In one.
All in one.
Right.
Dump
there.
It in the tub. Yeah.
That's in case you're really jacked up.
Yeah. Fall off your snowboard,
right.
Wipe out on your motorcycle, you know, come off your horse.
Well, you know what? I loved everything that you brought out here. You think?
No, those are mine. Those
are
my favorite.
These are mine.
Oh.
And the chapstick. But I'm going to come over here
I got
and talk
more
to
bags.
Brandon.
Yeah, Brandon's all ready for you. Got some concentrates. Right. I'm going to give you this to go talk with him about this amazing product from SPP.
All right, SPP. We're going over to Brandon.
Awesome.
Hey man, well, how's it going, man?
All right, how you doing, man?
Good.
You doing good?
Good.
All right. So I seen spread one, spread two. We're gonna count this spread three. Why don't you tell me about that one?
We got the concentrate spread here. We got the high THC, high potency extracts over here.
Right.
We got a whole timeline starting over from the old school, the pressed hashes, the keefs, and we even got some slightly new school, some caviar. What this is a nugget that has been rolled around in oil and then covered in keef. You got every part right there.
Washington caviar. All right.
Getting on more down the timeline, we got some PHO and some BHO, some shatters, super high terpene and THC extractions right there.
Right. What else do we have here?
We got a bunch of fresh frozen. If you ever heard of live resin before, Manny, that right there is all fresh frozen material.
All right, it's grapefruit, huh?
Yeah, that is the grapefruit live resin from SubX. Sure does. Since they pull it off the plant and within a day, they blast it and make it into oil. Super fresh tasting.
Grapefruit. Can you eat that?
I wouldn't really suggest eating that. That's definitely much more of a tasty concentrate to dab up.
Right
here though, what you could have is this is some fresh bubble hash, what is typically called rosin today, or SHO, the show oil.
Right.
That is made 100% solventlessly just using micron screens and hash.
Really, huh?
Yep.
Bubble hash. So, because I heard that in Washington, you can't use any kind of liquids to make your resins, right?
For the medical market, they are not allowed to use any solvents to run any of their extractions. So this right here would be the only way a medical patient like you or I could make something like this, was by taking hash. And if you've ever seen anyone using a straightening iron and some micron screens,
this is what
they make right here.
They were talking about, what's that paper? Parchment paper.
Parchment paper and micron screens.
Yeah. And then you put it on a hair straightener and that's how you can make this, huh?
Yep.
Right. So how much weed would it take to make this much?
To take a gram right there, seeing as rosin only produces about 5% to 10% return depending on the material,
right. You
definitely need a lot more than you would need out of any BHO extraction, which typically boosts up to 20 to 22% yields.
Okay. So you get more when you're using the solvents?
Absolutely.
Okay.
But you definitely get a really nice, super clean, tasty product when you're not using any solvents.
Okay, right. And I like pure product, you know what I mean?
Don't we like that old school bubble hash?
I love the old school, man. You guys catch the old school in Washington. That's what I like. I'm
keeping it real.
You know? So you guys keep it real, man. Yeah, that's the shit.
Oh, yeah.
What else you got here, my friend? What the heck is this?
That's the shatter right there. That's what everyone rants and raves about. That right there is the Hawaiian Dutch preserved terpene
Hawaiian
shatter.
Dutch. Man, I have heard that, you know, the darker the oil, the better.
See, that can sometimes be true. Letting your crystals actually mature and finish out and get to that full amber color is really what we look for in our pot.
But how do you know when the crystals are mature enough on the plant?
It takes a lot of scientists and a master grower to constantly be looking at the plants, checking out the crystals, and just knowing the ratio of fully completed ones to unfully completed to get that nice ratio and high that we like.
All right. Now you say crystals. Those are also called trichomes?
Yeah.
The trichomes, okay. I got a few plants that I'm taking. Like 14,
yeah,
no, I guess. Hell yeah. Christmas trees, you know. So, but my trichomes are actually starting to produce on my plant now because it's in the budding season.
Nice.
It's an outdoor plant, and they're looking really good. You know, I think I got one indica or one sativa in my group. The rest are indica.
Nice.
It's not nice, man. I'm a sativa person. I don't like indica too much.
Need those hot summers for those sativas, man.
Yeah, the hot summers in Colorado are pretty good, but I love my sativas. So. What else do you have here? What's this? This looks like
that meal. Right there, this is CO2. That is the product that was first used before distillates were made, and this is commonly what people will use today to turn into these really fine distillates and oils right here.
You know, when I first showed one of the syringes, a buddy of mine goes, "Are you gonna inject that?" I said, "No, Tim, I'm not gonna inject it. This is not the type that you inject in your veins, Tim. You know what I'm talking about." So, man, this all looks good, right? And I can't wait. So what do you have you want me to try?
I got a special product for you to try here, Manuel. This is the Bubba Scout by the North Coast Concentrates.
Bubba Scout, North Coast Concentrates. I appreciate it, my friend.
Absolutely, Manuel. Hey, you have fun.
Hospitality here in Washington was great, man. I can't show you guys enough love. So I'm gonna go say goodbye to Wendy and Nick, and then I'm gonna head to the Hemp Fest. Make sure you stay tuned and join us, all right? Nick, what's
up?
Hey,
Manny. See, you're getting a few more products there for you.
Oh, yeah, man. I picked something that I like out of each spread. So, yeah. You know, that's good. You guys really took care of me, man. I appreciate it.
Cool. We're glad we could do that. I had a little shout out I wanted to give to the Prime Minister of England. We are, at the moment, you know, we're getting independent from Europe and everyone's worried about the economy. And I have a little suggestion for her. Legalize cannabis and hemp.
Legalize today.
Yeah, legalize today. Very simple, look at the statistics from Colorado and Washington. Crime's falling, tourist numbers increasing, house prices are rising, and look at all the taxes that are pouring into those states. How could you not want that? It can also really help ease in the NHS, just these little simple non-psychoactive tinctures with CBD dominant tinctures, even the topicals would really help, because as you just heard from Wendy, there's lots of medical benefits to these. And then also when you're in the cabinet and things aren't going quite to plan, just grab a small joint and pass it around and everyone will be happy. So Britain was, yeah, there you go, Manny shows you how to do it.
Really easy.
But you know, Britain was used to rule the waves. How did Britain rule the waves? It was with hemp products. So we need to bring hemp back. You can use hemp for to replace steel, concrete, insulation, textiles, paper. It's also really good protein. You can bioremediate soils and it's going to help fight greenhouse gases. So it's a pretty amazing plant.
Yep, I take it back.
Yep, so either, you know, you in the UK or the new president in the US should bring this plant back. It was the economy of the world. It should be the economy of the world. It's just a simple plant and it will change the world again. How much more simple can you be just growing a plant?
Think last bit.
Hey, and you know why we're saving the planet? We're into saving marriages too.
Oh, I know. Whoa. I feel you there. Look at that. Yeah. Oh, did I bite you out?
Yeah, just got to get your joint too. That's right, we'll get that one for later.
All right.
So let's